What parts of your own wedding were you reminded of, or what do you like to look back on most fondly?
Oh my goodness, there's so many amazing memories from our wedding. I think for me, like our vows to each other, we wrote them personally, and I'll never forget the look in his eyes when he spoke to me, and it was just so real, and I felt everything that he was saying, and so I'll never forget the way he looked at me at that moment when we were saying our vows.
And also, her coming down the aisle, you know what I mean? It's just like, we get to experience that with everybody that's watching their significant other come down the aisle. It's just, it's a moment that you just, to me, it's just kind of burned in my memory, you know what I mean? Because you never forget that. And also, I was ugly crying, you know what I mean? I've said this so many times. I was a mess. As a matter of fact, do you remember when you got down there? She was kind of like, so I lifted the veil off, and she was like, babe.
Right here, we're doing this together.
She was so beautiful. It was awesome. It was fun. I mean, look at her, and now imagine her in a wedding dress and just floating. You know what I mean? It was just like, oh, it was crazy. I couldn't take it.
And I have to mention, though, it was one of my favorite moments, and it has nothing to do with even us. But when I was walking down the aisle, Nigel Lithgow, we actually used his vineyard for our wedding, and he offered up, you know, it to us, and it was so beautiful. But he was so excited for us to get married that the whole time I was walking down the aisle, he was right at my side, like taking pictures, and cheering me on. I was like, you can do this. So everyone else is sitting, standing, but at their chairs. And he was like walking the aisle with me. Yeah. And it was like,
Nigel is legit in mad photos. Like, he's like that dude in the background, just like proud papa.
Yeah, proud papa for sure. So that was really cool. And then speaking of dance, though, our reception had the most amazing dance party you could have ever imagined.
Yeah, it was
everyone. And we were just looking at photos and and videos from our wedding, and like everyone in the dance world was there and having a good time together, just dancing on the dance floor. So it was amazing.
Absolutely, yeah.
So what's it like being a part of a couple's special day, knowing that they're gonna have memories of like that to share on their own?
I mean, it's nothing short of incredible. It's just like these, you know, they're going to remember these days forever. And it's also really, really great to be in a position where, you know, if we can have a word with them before or something like that, to give them like kind words and reminders that people gave us, right? Like, you know what I mean? We had, I think, a couple different people tell us at different times during our day, hey, make sure you soak it in. Hey, make sure you take a little time to boom. Or after the ceremony's over, make sure you take a little time with each other. So being able to pass those kind of reminders on to other people, I think is incredibly special, because that day goes by like this. You know what I mean? It's all of this prep time and all of these plans and this and that, and then once it goes, it's gone.
It's
gone. Yeah. You know? Yeah. And if you're not careful, you know, you're greeting everybody, you're eating, you're doing this, and then the day is over and you haven't had a moment with each other yet. And I think that's one of the most I remember that being one of the most special things that somebody told us to do, is to make sure that we actually took a moment for ourselves after everything was said and done. Absolutely.
So did you guys get any inspiration from any of the couples being like, oh man, I wish we would have thought of that for our wedding? You guys could do a vow renewal down the line or an anniversary celebration.
You know what? That would be awesome, actually. Yeah.
Yeah.
Of course. Yeah.
I don't think we would change anything about how our wedding went or our reception. It was just exactly how it was supposed to be, and it was so perfect. But then there's some people that like really involve their families into things and do new things.
Yeah.
So I think if we ever throw a new party or do renew our vows, we know we'd want to add to it for sure.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
And you guys are coming up on your fifth anniversary this year. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
So besides wedding tips for the day of, what wisdom did you guys share for the couples for after the wedding and married life? What's the best part of married life for you guys?
I mean, best part, honestly, is having somebody that not only has your best interests at heart, but somebody that for me is like that I truly consider like my better half. Do you know what I'm saying? So then you have those days that are the for better or worse. On those worst days, then you have literally the best to have your back and have your side and lift you up, exactly, no matter what's going on. And then also to give you the truth about what's going on. You know what I mean? Everybody out here can be telling you whatever, but you have somebody that knows your insides and outsides and knows exactly like kind of like what you need to hear, whether you're ready to hear it or not. Do you know what I'm saying? So it's just like that's that's priceless. That's what that's honestly one of the best things about marriage to me, is having a partner in crime, like, yeah, for life. You know what I mean?
And then, like, the advice I'd give a couple too is it's really important to explore who you are individually. You know, mm-hmm, it's really easy to be with someone all the time, mm-hmm, that you get caught up in each other's world and you kind of forget about your own individual, mm-hmm, world. And that's the thing I think we've both learned, is it's really important for him to have his thing, really important for me to have my thing. Mm-hmm. And then that's what's really exciting about having a relationship, though, is because you can grow now from each other. Mm-hmm. You know, because I have a different life, he has a different life, and we sometimes come together and can talk about it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And we can share in that, and we can share in those moments. And, you know, we also find it really important in our lives to keep growing. And so we always are like, we're always, mm-hmm, reading books and learning and sharing that information with each other. And so I think we're always, you know, we're on this journey together, mm-hmm, but also for ourselves as people.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. And any more kids in the future, you think?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
More kids in the future, mm-hmm, for sure.
Oh, yeah. In due time. Right. Listen, in due time. Absolutely. You know, I used to holler out the number 7, you know what I mean? But that was, A, before I realized that I was not the one having the children, and then, B, before I witnessed childbirth. You know what I'm saying? Then it was. Then I was like, okay, you know what? You can set the number. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got it. You get it.